Good morning, children. We have completed our first two chapters. Our first two chapters are related to rational numbers. I think all of you have studied that two chapters. Now we are moving to our next chapter, that is our fourth chapter, properties of quadrilaterals. Okay, that is our fourth chapter, properties of quadrilaterals. You already know, you have studied what is a quadrilateral. Can you say some example for quadrilaterals? All of you can say what is quadrilateral. Examples. First example, square, then square is a quadrilateral, then rectangle is a quadrilateral. Then what is quadrilateral? Quadrilateral means is it a quadrilateral? Yes, it is a quadrilateral. Then what is a quadrilateral? Quadrilateral is a four-sided polygon formed by four line segments. Okay, four-sided polygon formed by four line segments that intersect at the end point or vertices. These four line segments are intersecting at the end point. This is the end point of first and second, and this is the end point of these two and these two, and four vertices are there. So it is a quadrilateral, four-sided polygon formed by four line segments that intersect at the end point, or it is the vertices. Okay, suppose we can say that this is quadrilateral PQRS, and here we have four sides. Which are the four sides of the quadrilateral? PQ, QR, sides. Here we have four sides. They are PQ, then PQ, then QR, QR, RS, and SP. These are the four sides, and here we have four vertices or four corners. Corners are also called vertices. Okay, vertex. It is one of the vertex and another vertex, corners. That is vertices. Okay, here we have four vertices. They are P, Q, R, S. So four vertices are there, and four angles. We can say that angle P, angle Q, angle R, angle S. Four angles are there. Four interior angles. These angles are inside the quadrilateral. So we can say that they are interior angles. Okay. Then, so now we discussed what is vertices, then sides of a quadrilateral, then angles of a quadrilateral. Then we can join the opposite vertices. Opposite. Here P and R, they are the opposite vertices, Q and S, another vertices, and here we Q is one vertex and its opposite vertex is S. Okay, and here P and R, they are another pair of opposite vertices, and we join PR. Now we have two lines PR and QS. They are the diagonals of the quadrilateral. Diagonals. Okay, diagonals means joining the line, joining the opposite vertices. Okay, that is diagonals. Next, opposite sides. Which are the opposite sides? Here PQ and SR, opposite sides. Opposite sides. Here PQ, sorry, PQ and SR. They are opposite sides QR and PS. They are also opposite sides. Then opposite angles P and R. P R opposite angles. Then Q S. Another opposite angles. Okay, so two pairs of opposite angles and two pairs of opposite sides. Next, adjacent side. Adjacent side. Adjacent sides. Adjacent sides means PQ and QR. PQ, QR. They are adjacent sides. Then QR and RS. Another pair is QR and RS. Next pair is RS and SP. RS and SP. And one more pair is the, that is SP and PQ. SP and PQ. So four pairs of adjacent angles, PQ and QR, they are adjacent sides. QR and RS, adjacent sides. RS and SP, adjacent sides. Then SP and PQ, they are also adjacent sides. Okay, next, adjacent angles. Adjacent angles. Adjacent angles. Which are the adjacent angles? Here P and Q, they are adjacent angle. P and R, they are opposite angles. Here angle P and angle Q, they are adjacent angles. Angle P, angle Q, adjacent angles. Angle Q and angle R. Angle Q and angle R. Then angle R and angle S. Then angle S and angle P, adjacent angles. Okay, these are the four pairs of adjacent angles. Okay, then next we have two types of quadrilaterals. Two types of quadrilaterals, they are convex, convex convex quadrilaterals and concave. Convex quadrilaterals and concave quadrilaterals. Okay, I'm going to draw two quadrilaterals here. Is it a quadrilateral? Here four sides are there, 1, 2, 3, 4, and they are intersecting at the end point. Four vertices are there, so we can say that it is a quadrilateral. Four sides and four angles. And another quadrilateral. Okay, here I'm taking it is A B C D. It is quadrilateral A B C D, and here P Q R S, two quadrilaterals. Okay, and we can draw the diagonals. Here we have two diagonals P R and Q S. Here also we can draw two diagonals. It is A B C D. Okay, here we will get two diagonals. Here AC and DB, BD, these are the two diagonals. Here PR and QS, two diagonals. Here in this figure, in the quadrilateral PQRS, the two diagonals are inside the quadrilateral. Okay, here PR and QS, these two diagonals are inside the quadrilateral. And what about this quadrilateral? It is PABCD. This is our quadrilateral, and ABCD means it is AB is our one of the diagonal, and it is diagonals. BD and AC, they are the diagonals. And here AC, what about the diagonal AC? Is it inside the quadrilateral or outside the quadrilateral? AC, the diagonal AC is outside the quadrilateral, and the diagonal BD is inside the quadrilateral. Okay, in this figure, in this quadrilateral PQRS, two diagonals are inside the quadrilateral. Here one of the diagonal is outside the quadrilateral. Okay, so if the diagonals, of the quadrilateral are inside the quadrilateral, we can say that convex quadrilateral. So it is a convex quadrilateral because the two diagonals are inside the quadrilateral. And here it is a concave quadrilateral. Why it is concave? Because one of the diagonal is outside the quadrilateral, therefore it is called a concave quadrilateral. Clear? Convex and what is convex and concave quadrilateral. Okay, then angle sum of a quadrilateral. We know what is angle sum of a triangle. Suppose we have a triangle ABC. Angle sum property of a triangle, we have studied angle sum property of a triangle. That is, if the sum of three angle will be angle A plus angle B plus angle C plus angle, sorry, it is a triangle only up to angle C only, equal to angle A plus angle B plus angle C is equal to 180 degree. Okay, sum of three angles of a quadrilateral is 180 degree. And next we are going to prove, what about the sum of interior angles, sum of four angles of a, what is the sum of four angles of a quadrilateral? Okay, sum of interior angle of a quadrilateral. Listen, do you know what is interior angle and exterior angle? Here we have quadrilateral PQRS. We can say this angle as angle P or angle SPQ or QPS. Okay, we can name this angle in different ways. Okay, here angle P, it is angle Q, angle R and angle S. These four angles are inside the quadrilateral, therefore they are the interior angles. Okay, and next we can mark the exterior angles. It is the exterior angle P, this is exterior angle Q, exterior angle R, exterior angle S. So we can mark the exterior angles like this. Okay, so first we are going to prove what is the sum of interior angle of a quadrilateral. Here we have a quadrilateral PQRS. We need to find the sum of interior angle. What will be the sum of interior angle of this quadrilateral? We can take only the interior angles. Okay. Listen, it is quadrilateral PQRS. And we can divide every quadrilateral into two triangles, and this is a triangle. It is triangle, we can take it as triangle PQS and SRQ. We have two triangles, and we know the sum of interior angles of a triangle is 180 degree. So in triangle PQS, angle P plus, and it is angle Q. So we can take this small angle as angle 1. Okay, and here it is angle S, and for triangle, first triangle PQS, we have only this part. Okay, so we can take it as angle 2. Then in this triangle also we can take this angle and this one, it is 3 and it is angle 4. So in the triangle PQS we have 3 angles, angle P plus, angle 1 plus angle 2 equal to 180 degree. Okay, and what about angle triangle QRS? In triangle QRS, angle 3 plus angle 4 plus angle R equal to 180 degree. Okay, we have divided our quadrilateral PQRS into two triangles, PQS and QRS, two triangles, PQS and QRS. And sum of three angles in the first triangle is 180 degree, and here also it is equal to 180 degree. Okay, so this quadrilateral PQRS means triangle PQS plus triangle QRS. Okay, so we can add these two angles, angle PQS plus angle QRS equal to, suppose it is equation 1 and it is equation 2, and we are adding 1 plus 2 equal to, first we can add the LHS, angle P plus angle 1 plus angle 2 plus LHS of the second equation, angle 3 plus angle 4 plus angle R equal to, and add the RHS, that is 180 plus 180. Okay. Here angle 1 plus 2 and angle 3 plus 4, we can take these four angles. Here angle Q equal to, this angle Q is divided into two angles, that is angle 1 and angle 4. So angle 1 plus angle 4 equal to, angle 1 plus angle 4 equal to angle Q, and angle 2 plus angle 3 equal to, angle 2 plus angle 3 equal to angle S. Okay, so instead of this angle 1 and angle 4, we can try, we can, otherwise we can rewrite this as angle P plus angle 1 plus angle 4, because angle 1 plus angle 4 equal to Q, we can write angle 1 and angle 4 together, plus angle 3 plus angle 2 plus angle R equal to 180 plus 180 is 360 degree. Okay, then angle P plus angle 1 plus Q, we can substitute angle 1 plus angle 4 equal to angle Q. So, instead of this angle 1 plus angle 4, we can write angle Q plus angle 3 plus angle 4 is equal to angle S, this angle. Angle S plus angle R equal to 360 degree. So, angle P plus, we need to prove sum of interior angle of a quadrilateral. Okay, then angle P plus, angle Q plus, angle S plus, angle R equal to 360 degree. Here, sum of these four angles is equal to 360 degree. So, we can say that sum of four interior angles of a quadrilateral is 360 degree. Okay, then quadrilateral means four sided figure. Then what about the interior angle, sum of interior angle of other polygons? That means pentagon, hexagon, octagon, like that we have many polygons. Suppose I am taking a figure with a pentagon, figure with four sides. Sorry, pentagon means five sides. It is a pentagon. And it is a quadrilateral, and to prove the sum of interior angles, we divided this into two triangles and 180 equal to 360 degree. Sum of interior angle of a quadrilateral, okay, that is 360 degree, because here we have two triangles. Okay, its sum is, sum of these three angle will be 180 degree, and sum of these two and sum of these three angles are also 180 degree. Okay, and here how can we prove? Here also we can divide this pentagon into three triangles, 1 2 3, three triangles are here. Okay, so it is its sum. Here the sum of these three angles will be 180 degree. It is its sum also equal to 180 degree, and sum of these three angles are also equal to 180 degree. Okay, so the sum of interior angles of a pentagon, that is 180 plus 180 plus 180 equal to, or otherwise 3 into 180. Okay, that is 540. So sum of interior angle of a pentagon is 540. Then we can take a hexagon. Hexagon means another polygon with six sides. Here, how many triangles will be there? First diagonal, 1. In a quadrilateral, we can divide by drawing one of the diagonal, we can divide that quadrilaterals into two triangles. Here, three triangles. Then, here, four triangles. Okay. Four triangles. So, sum of interior angle of a hexagon is equal to these six angles, what will be the sum? Here we will have one 180, another 4 triangles are there. So 180 plus 180 plus 180 plus 180 or 4 into 180. So sum of interior angle of a hexagon is 720. Okay, so for a quadrilateral it is, if it is a quadrilateral, its sum of interior angle is, here we have, it is a four sided figure, therefore here we have two triangles. Okay, and it is a four sided figure, then here we will get two triangles, therefore sum of interior angle is equal to 2 into 180 degree. Okay, and here it is a five sided figure, and to get the sum of interior angles of this pentagon, it is 3 into 180. And here it is a six-sided figure, to get the sum of interior angle of this hexagon, we multiplied 4 into 180. Okay, suppose we are taking a figure, octagon, 8 sides. Octagon means how many sides are here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 sides are there. Okay, then how many triangles will be there? It is 8-sided figure, then how can we find sum of interior angles? It is 8-sided figure. So, how many triangles will be there? 6 triangles. So, 6 into 180 degree. If it is a figure with 11-sided figure, how many triangles will be there? 11 minus 2. If there is 4-sided figure, sum of interior angles equal to 2 into 180. That means there will be 2 triangles. Okay, pentagon means 3 into 180. That is 5-sided figure means 3 into 180. That is 5 minus 2. So, here 11 minus 2. That is 9 into 180 degree. Okay, so if the number of side of a polygon is, suppose we have a n number of sides polygon. We have a polygon with n number of sides. How can we find the sum of interior angles of that polygon? N minus 2. N minus 2 triangle will be there. N minus 2 into 180 degree. Okay, if it is a four sided figure, sum of interior angle is equal to 4 minus 2 into 180 degree, that is 2 into 180 degree. For a quadrilateral, to get the sum of interior angle of a quadrilateral, 2 into 180 degree, that is there we have 4 sides, that 4 minus 2 into 180 degree. And for a five-sided figure, 5 minus 2 into 180, that is 3 into 180. Okay, so we can say that to get the sum of interior angles of a polygon, we can use this formula, that is n minus 2 into 180 degree. Here n is the number of sides. Okay, I think it is clear. Here today we have discussed a polygon. What is a polygon? It is a four-sided figure. Okay, quadrilateral. What is a quadrilateral? Quadrilateral is a four-sided polygon. Okay, formed by four line segments that intersect at the end point. Here we have a polygon. It is four-sided figure. So it is called a quadrilateral. Okay, and sum of interior angle of a quadrilateral. Sum of interior angle of a quadrilateral is 360 degree. Okay, so from this sum of interior angle of a quadrilateral, we can find out the how to find sum of interior angles of any polygon using this formula, n minus 2 into 180 degree. Here n is the number of sides. Clear? Okay, that's all for today. Thank you.